globe is nearly impossible. So we think of it like a pinball, you know, that the signal goes up and it bounces around the ionosphere and eventually kind of pops back, right? And finally taking enough hops through the ionosphere to get to the other station. When we talk about hops, for example, on the E layer, we start at the D, where we are now, okay, the D layer, just over the stratosphere. And the E layer, right above that, the maximum you can usually get out of the E layer is about 1,200 miles. And that's why sometimes you'll hear people talking about sporadic E or E skip, because they were able to get that that good angle into the E layer and have it reflect down and have it bounce around. Well, that same propagation, we think of it as point A and then the ionosphere and then point B is the target station. However, it doesn't always happen that way. Sometimes you take multiple hops through that E layer, and sometimes it'll break through that E layer, and it's called a refraction at that point. It will refract through that E layer and catch the F1. And today, that was occurring on 10 meter FM. I was able to hear stations that I should not, that I literally could not hear on 10 meters in the AM portion or in the sideband portion. I could not hear those stations. However, up on 29 megacycles, I was hearing those stations. And I was going back and forth between 28.385 and 29.300 just to check the propagation. So, propagation, there's a lot of artistry here, and there is a lot of mystery here, but we have the sun on our side. It's an amazing thing that's happening. It's pretty exciting for some of us who've experienced zero sunspots for over a year. That's the time you take the microphone off the radio, you throw it in the drawer, and you forgot where you put it. It's been terrible, but now we know that they totally missed the prediction on the solar cycle, and we're very happy to have this type of propagation now.